Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Honorable my supervisors, Ms. Risa Sandrizkia, MPD as the first supervisor, Mr. Arham Mauryat, SIKOM MAT Sol, as the second supervisor, and the honorable examiners of this final assignment examination in this special occasion. I'm Adiyusi Meliani Putri, student of English Education Department, IKIP Siliwangi, Bandung. I would like to thank you to my supervisors and the examiners who give me opportunity to present about my research paper with the title Increasing Descriptive Speaking Skill of Eighth Grade Student Using Guessing Games. My research paper consists of 5 chapters. Chapter 1 is introduction, chapter 2 is literature review, chapter 3 is research methodology, chapter 4 is research and discussion, and the last one is chapter 5 is conclusion and suggestion. Chapter 1, introduction. Background of the research. Teacher play important role in fostering motivation and enthusiasm for student learning. As stated in the Republic of Indonesia number 20 of 2003, teachers are responsible for assisting students in acquiring new knowledge, developing competency, and understanding learning standard. To generate learning motivation and increase student understanding, learning media is needed. Learning media, as defined by Ratu Heru and Saliman, are tools or objects used in teaching and learning activity to convey message or information from teacher to student. To help with this research, researchers choose to use a guessing game as a medium for learning and improving speaking skill. Merriam-Webster defines guessing game as an activity in which individuals compete to guess something based on the clue given. It is hoped that guessing game can provide an opportunity for students who are shy and feel less activity for participate in learning tough guessing game so that they can be more active in participating in learning, so that it can help increase student descriptive speaking skill. Next is research question. I have 3 research questions in my research. The first one is guessing game effective in improving descriptive speaking skill? The second one is how do the student respond to use of guessing game in the learning process? And the last one is what obstacle were encountered student during the use guessing game. Next is objective of the research. The effect of guessing game and speaking skill. Next, find out responses of student with guessing game in learning process. And the last one is obstacle encountered in implementation of guessing game. Significant of the research. I define and decide significant of the research into 4 categories. For the first is for researcher, next for student, the third for English teacher, and the last one is for future researcher. Next is chapter 2, literature review. Next is preview study. I use 7 preview study in my research paper. From all the research results, it is stated that guessing game is effective and can increase student skill. And my research also found that guessing game is effective for increasing descriptive speaking skill of 8th grade student in one of junior high school in Bandung. What distinguishes my research from review study, it show from the sample, skill, method, and research design used. Move to chapter 3, research methodology. Research methodology. For research method, I choose mixed method. Mixed method is the research approach that combines quantitative and qualitative research. Next, for research design, I choose sequential explanatory design, where in the first stage the research was carried out using quantitative and the second stage with qualitative subject of the research. My research subject are 33 students of age junior high school in West Bandung. Instrument of the research. For instrument, I have two instruments, quantitative and qualitative. For quantitative, I choose test and questionnaire. And for qualitative, I choose interview for my instrument. Data collection and analysis. Pre-test and post-test. Pre-test and post-test is a test conducted to measure student's skill before and after treatment. Data analysis consists with three activities. The first is input data, next data processing with SPSS, and the last one is data interpretation. Next is questionnaire. Is collecting information by conveying a number of written questions to be answered by student. Data analysis consists four activities. The first one is editing data. The next is coding data using Likert scale. Next, input the data to SPSS. And the last one is interpretation result. Next is interview. Interview is collecting information by asking a number of questions, verbal, and answer by verbally too. Data analysis consists of three activities. The first one is data reduction, the next one is data presentation, and the last one is drawing conclusion. Next is chapter 4, research and discussion. The first one is the effect improving descriptive speaking skill using a single game. The first research question, the result, the data was obtained from the pretest and posttest, where the process quantitatively using SPSS. Data on the pretest, the average student score is 9.06, while on posttest, the average student score is 15.24, with maximal score is 20. The data is normally distributed. Significancy value is 0.109 and 0.108 are greater than the 0.05 significant level. For the hypothesis is smaller than 0.055 significant level, consequently, the null hypothesis is rejected. From this data, it can be concluded that there is an increasing on student score before and after being given treatment with guessing games. Next is the student response of using guessing game in learning process. The next data is questionnaire data. To answer research question number 2, the questionnaire itself is processed quantitative using SPSS. Before using the questionnaire data in research, the validity and reliability tests were first carried out with the research. The first one, the validity test of 20 questions, is valid. And for the reliability test, result is 0.910 with good internal consistency. And with the result, the questionnaire can use on research. Next, after distributing the data, It is collected and processed using SPSS to get the average value at or score of the questionnaire, and the result is the average result of the percentage of student questionnaire answer is 75.9% with the category almost all of student helpfully guessing game to increase descriptive speaking skill. The last research result to answer research question number 3 is by interview. The interview data is qualitative, which is the process by reducing and data presentation and drawing conclusion. Result of interview is a difficulty in grammar, comprehension, and vocabulary. For a distance learning, the first one is refers to study using guessing game, and the second one is prefers to study serious and prefer to use textbook. And the last concept development, the idea is visible that students want to fun learning by playing games, but there are also students who want to be serious and learn only with textbook. It can be concluded that it is better if students are lagging according to learning what they want. It is for students to get the material more quickly be delivered. The last chapter is chapter 5, conclusion and suggestion. And I have three conclusion. For the first one is there was a significant difference between a pre-test score and post-test score before the treatment and after the treatment. For the second conclusion, its questionnaire had previously had been tested for validity and reliability. The result obtained for 33 students were 75.9% in the student presentation category, which means that almost all students agree that guessing game help them improve or increase their descriptive speaking skill. For the last conclusion, that is necessary to add or mix game and material in learning, so that learning is not boring and monotone. I have presented all the content of my research paper from chapter 1 until chapter 5. That's all my presentation. Thank you so much for your nice attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.